Well, you click on it, I'm already connected.
To the only thing I can think to do is get back where mine was.
So it says one plus T-Mobile. When I got that phone call, while ago, I bet they took it off.
Yeah, well, if that's the case, we'll stick with this for now. We'll see how it goes. And if it does, if we do have to switch it over, you're going to have to turn your phone off.
I got it on silent now.
I'm saying if it turns off your hotspot when you make a phone call, then you can't be kicking it off.
You want to warm up? Show off a little bit?
You want that
already turned it on?
The stream is on yet.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, everybody. Welcome.
All right, everyone's going to warm up and show off a little bit. Then, if you bought a VIP ticket, you went into a bucket to be pulled. We're going to pull, but we already did pull earlier. 20 random people to come up and play Efren. You'll get 2 racks. You can pick 8, 9, or 10 balls. 2 racks against him. You'll also get a picture and an autograph. Efren can stick around afterwards. Please don't ask for autographs if you're not called until he is done. Since Rich won't talk, I'm supposed to fill this time.
All right, everybody. Welcome to Lone Wolf Pool Network. We're coming to you live today from Raleigh, North Carolina. We're at Brass Tap Billiards. Right now, Efren is warming up. Efren's going to play 20 different exhibition matches versus some of the local players here.
It looks fairly straight there, right?
Not really.
I mean,
a little, yeah.
Right now, Lone Wolf Pool Network staff is still just setting up everything, getting ready to go. Efren's going to warm up for a few minutes.
I wonder if that thing moved.
It moved.
It
for
just
sure.
Looked like just a second ago, it was like all kinds of. All right, whatever. If it stays there, it stays there.
Okay, so what they said, for signatures, autographs, pictures, after he's finished tonight, we'll set him up back here at 14. It's $10. Cash, $10. Please make change and have exactly $10 when you come back. There's no register back here.
All right, everybody, I'm going to turn the microphone off until we get ready to start commentating everything. You all should be able to hear everything that's going on.
While he's warming up, does anybody have any questions they want to ask him? You raise your hand, I'll come around to you. Anything you want to know? Y'all make this really hard.
Did you just change the color?
I didn't change what. I'm over here. I ain't touch nothing.
Yes, ma'am.
You figure Angie would be one to ask first questions.
Oh, Angela wants to know, what was your favorite tournament you've ever played in?
World Championships.
World Championships? Did y'all hear?
World Championships.
What year?
1999, the World Championship. Did you win that?
Oh.
you on that one.
Who got second?
Who got second?
Chinese guy.
You don't know. That's a long time ago.
I don't remember. Yeah, that was big.
We got house cues all over the place. It's not like you're going to shoot that much.
It's not like you're going to shoot that much. Rude.
All right, Melissa wants to be skipped so she can get her own cues. She thinks she's going to be skipped.
All right, everybody, the first matchup is going to be Efren versus Melissa Goss.
All right, next one. I'm going to say the setup again, but Ray, you're up 8, 9, or 10 ball. Come on, Efren. Beat his ass.
So is
Melissa's going to get her sticks.
Okay, so who jumped up first, Ray?
Ray.
All right, so Efren's going to play Ray first, guys. He's playing two racks versus everybody.
I got a question.
They get to choose whether they play 8 ball, 9 ball, or 10 ball.
Although I know he plays all the time.
Efren. Mike over there wants to know, how good of a chess player are you? Just a little, Mike.
Is that better than you?
He's not a master. He'll try you, though.
Is he out of rank?
No rank. He'll try you, though, he said.
I'll offer to play for money based on the chess we've been asking. Hey, my brother plays for $10. Yeah, he tried to play.
Chris is very smart. So the next person that'll play Efren, so you get your
I gotta be
ready.
Careful with y'all say this thing got closed cap.
Well, yeah, Melissa, so she'll get your
Chris
sticks ready.
The word. The next.
And then Shane Hardy.
What you say?
Shane, are you around here somewhere?
Shane,
that's a different one. Tell us about your name. Yes. I'll keep saying that. You know what? I'll just call them all out. That way y'all get your sticks ready. All right. Shane Hardy. Glenn Russell. Robin House. Jackie Rose. Jim Smith. Eli. Captain Eli. You.
Bring your mind right.
Jay?
You know you can.
Jay? All right.
Angela.
Troy? Troy G? I know he came in. I seen him. Okay. Machine? I seen him already. Bobby Brown? Doug Parks? I haven't seen Doug.
Kyle?
Doug Parks, if you out there listening
Chuck
in the parking lot, they just call your name to play, Doug.
Ron I and Ricky Dixon.
We'll keep on calling.
Damn, he
said
it right in front of me.
I love Shane.
All right, Doug Parks, they just call your name to come in and play. So, Doug Parks, if you listening, you get to play against Efren Reyes. You need to come on inside. All right, Ray scraps on the break.
Tell Doug if you don't hear, Francis takes next
Again, they called your name to play against the Efren. So if you inside or if you're right outside, you need to come on inside, buddy.
I'm gonna go outside and look for him.
Reyes getting a chance here. This is the second rack. Everybody only gets to play two racks versus Efren Reyes.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Tammy.
Yes, sir.
Doug's at the gas station. He said he'd be his truck. Okay. Efren wins 2-0 against me. They pose for a picture. His next opponent will be Melissa Goff. Alright, everybody, give me 1 second. But Melissa chose nine balls, so she's going to play Efren 2 racks and nine balls. We'll be right back.
What's a USB hub look like?
No, it's over on the table.
We're back.
Yeah.
All right, Melissa has a chance right here to beat Efren. All right, everybody, just testing out. Let me know if y'all can hear me okay.
Officially met, have we?
Yeah, I've seen you a few times.
Everybody's memory changes.
Famous like this guy.
What's that?
Famous like this guy.
Yeah, yeah. He's world famous, though. I'm just wrong.
Where do you play out?
Break time is closest to my house, but I might play once a week.
All right, Melissa's got a chance to beat Efren 2-0.
So now your mic is working, and this one is not, although I got power. This one's not.
Yeah, because it was turned off. Alright, so Efren and Melissa split. I'll let y'all know who he's playing next. Who? Who did she say? Okay. So Wayne will be up next. Glenn Russell actually won, but he gave his spot away to Wayne. And he chose 8-ball.
I think they should play rotation. Thank you.
Robbie House, you're up next.
Now they should both be working. All right, everybody, let me know if you can hear me. That's probably way too loud. They playing eight ball, right?
Yeah.
Be a nice shot. So that's a cardinal sit an eight ball to miss the eight ball and leave a wide open table. You got to expect that Efren is going to get out from here.
Have her.
Damn, Wayne, we thought you had that one.
So Efren won that one.
Yeah, that was a nice try by Wayne there. He did pretty well, got all the way down the eight ball, hung it up. Using a second ball break?
Yep.
That's why I hate the the rail break in eight ball. Just so many clusters.
Thank you.
20 of them will be more after they're done.
Efren is working his way around the table here.
Just in VIP tickets.
Seems a little surreal to be in the building with one of the greatest to ever play the game. And he takes down Wayne 2-0. I'll let you know who's up next. After everybody plays two racks, guys, it takes a couple minutes because they give everybody a picture, everybody who's a VIP player. Next up is a fan favorite here. We got Robbie House.
Joe, your sheetrock finisher wishes he was getting $50 ahead to be in here right now.
What did Robbie choose? 10 ball? All right, Robbie calls push. Ball looked like he drifted just a hair to the left. Efren quickly gives it back. Guys, I don't know who's actually going to play. They have a list, and they call them out one by one. So you'll find out who he's playing as soon as I do.
Looks like he's shooting at it, so it must have leaked out. Oh, he did have to go rail first.
That ball held on for dear life and just falls off at the very end. Giving Efren ball in hand.
Does it tell you? doesn't tell you how many. I guess you have to look up the websites. I wonder if any are watching from YouTube. Have you looked at it on YouTube?
I got it.
Post on your page?
I think you might have put the wrong page. It should have been that one. The one with that logo.
This one right here, right?
Yeah.
Whatever account and password you gave is what it means. That's Facebook.
So, Dean, who won that one? Robbie won? All right, so Robbie gets a game on the legend. It's on the right one, Dave. It's the right one. That's the right account. It's live on Twitch.
A lot of juice.
Thank you. So they split 1-1, right?
Yep, I already marked up the score.
All right, Jackie won the next raffle, but she's being nice, giving
Rich. Who?
It's Father's Day.
Chris? Okay. All right, so Jackie Rose won the draw, but she's giving it to her husband, Chris Rose, for Father's Day. Let's see an update.
Chris has a very, very solid break.
Shane, you're next. You can get your sticks together.
That's not nice. That's one for Efren. If I was Chris, maybe I'd take a flyer at that nine ball. I mean, he's looking at it. I know some of them. Jessica, for the VIPs, which there were 50, they are drawing 20 of those 50 to play him and get a picture. After those 20 are going through, then they'll be doing challenge matches. I think it's $10 a person. It might be 20. But it's nothing that's going to hurt you, Jess. Kind of wants to hit the second rail here. Yeah, there we go. Efren's one pocket stroke should be pretty much dialed in. He's been playing a lot of one pocket with Mike Davis since he's been here in Raleigh. This should be pretty rudimentary. I think the 7-9's dead, so just make the 6, shoot 7. And Chris can say he took the game off the world's greatest player.
So Chris tied it up with him. That's a memory for a lifetime. He'll always be able to say he got a rack off of Efren Reyes. So that's a memory of a lifetime. Shane is up next.
So one of the questions was three cushion hole? You play that? Do you like that?
He played it before. He doesn't play it now.
They said he was really strong at it. He just said that was not his day. Hold on. One cushion and what? Back.
Say that.
Back rack. Back lock.
Ball nine.
Y'all figure it out. I don't play that neither. I play nothing. You want to play me? Do you want me to tell you my spot? I put you on the loser board over there.
Who? Shane. Yeah, that's Shane. Yeah, not Shane do good.
Nice combination. Unfortunately, didn't get shape. That was a good shot. So the question here isn't whether or not he can make a good hit. He can definitely go one rail. Question is what he needs to do in order to make it and get position on the five. Just trying to create some separation. And he got there. It looks like a full ball snooker. Not to take away from the current action of the greatest player to ever played pool versus the local folks here in Raleigh, but if anybody cares, the Shane and Dennis match is now 40-37 for Dennis.
Get the whole crowd. Take.
Lee, they just started back up a few minutes ago. It's 40-37 for Dennis. Dennis is at the table right now. For those of you that don't know, that's Shane Van Boning and Dennis Arcoyo. They're doing another race to 129 ball. This is the start of their second day. Safety playing kicks there. That's a good
right,
game to watch.
Efren won both of those, right? Yeah, because Shane is still standing up there. Sorry, that was...
I would say re-rack that, but that's pretty nasty.
That's how you're supposed to back when we get a break and run. Now we're going to live.
Whatever that, yeah.
Pass the record.
Here's a good chance for Shane to make some balls. Gonna have to play a combination after this, I think. This is no gimme. Although he's got, you know, he could get lucky and make the 10, but just needs to make the 9. And get position. That's twice now he's made a good combination, but didn't get shape on the first ball. Nice shot. Now with the 8 being close to the rail, it makes it a little bit easier to hit. Because you can go long, you can come well, you can't go short, but if you go long, you got two different ways you can hit the ball. It becomes bigger when it's closer to the rail. Two rails. Never fails. Hopefully we don't get booted.
The great one just missed a shot.
10 ball in the side. It wasn't that easy of a shot, but unexpectedly, he misses. Shane has a chance to win this rack.
Oh, you played a one pocket shot on Efren Reyes. Nice shot.
Shane gets the rack. Good shot at the end. All right, everybody. My name is Nicholas Rogers. I'm here live with David Baranski, coming to you from Brass Tap Billiards in Raleigh, North Carolina. For everybody who just tuned in, thank y'all for tuning in today. Everybody, do me a favor. Like and share the video.
We have
also
another question while you're playing. Everybody knows you from the Z shot, right? Everybody knows the Z shot. They want to know if anybody's ever used it on you.
I don't understand.
He doesn't. He doesn't understand.
Earl just said nobody's ever done the two rail bank shot on him. All right, everybody, do me a favor. Let me know what city and state y'all tuning in from. We really want to know how far we're getting our reach out there. So do me a favor as we get ready for the next player to line up against Efren. Y'all give me a hello, post where you're tuning in from. I don't know his name. I couldn't hear him. Tammy. What's his name?
Jim Smith.
Okay. Next up, we got Efren versus Jim Smith.
Say you'll give me about an hour to stop.
I do need to make an appointment. I just haven't had time. I finally got to the chiropractor. And then, of course, I missed my appointment. So how are you? How's your son doing?
Doing good. Oh, I see. The latest.
Efren takes that one and he gets ready to break.
Congratulations on the second one.
Efren, ever the sportsman and gentleman, after he's crashed, he went and grabbed the cue ball. He did that against Chris, too. Shane and Dennis update. Shane's up. Dennis is up 41-39. Shane's at the table. If any of you watched any of that last night, Dennis did put a 10-pack on Shane, and by 10-pack, I mean he broke it around 10 racks in a row. At 34-20, Dennis had broken run 20 games, and Shane had broken and run 17. So it's a lot of balls made on the break and a lot of runouts.
Is that right?
All right, Efren takes the second one.
You ready? Captain Eli is going to play run rack rhythm. Your stiffest competition today. Who do you want to break? You want to break him? You want to make him break? You want to make him break?
Nice. Good move. All right. That was
you guys are about to watch a young star be born here. Let's go, Eli.
How old is Eli? Seven?
Huh?
How old is Eli? Seven?
Six.
Six?
That was nice of Ricky. His dad won the spot. He gave it to his son.
Eli's been over there warming up since this started at 6:30.
Efren said he shows no mercy.
Might as well teach the young man life is hard right from the get, right? That's not very nice.
That's going to be a great picture right there with that little kid and Efren both staring at the table.
What do you say? Show them what you got, buddy. Nice.
That's good. That's good. Oh, man. Good try, young man. Efren said he better go on to close this out.
Did.
Good try, Eli. So Brandon is filling in for the Eli's other rack. So this is just going to be a race to one here.
Oh, look out.
Thank you. I got it.
Scratch on the break being punished by Efren. Who's playing now?
Who's playing?
You know that? Hold on, I can't.
We've heard rumors that the person playing Efren's name is Red, so we're going to go with that. Is he gonna get him? It's close. I think he did get him.
Thank you.
Welcome to the stream. Mark Bolton, Tim Green, Stephen Parker. Thank y'all for tuning in. Lance Giddens. I appreciate y'all joining the crowd and tuning in to watch Efren here. Again, for everybody who just tuned in while we're on the in between racks, let y'all know we're coming to you live from Raleigh, North Carolina. We're at Brass Tap Billiards, 3616 Capitol Boulevard in Raleigh, North Carolina. My name is Nicholas Rogers, the owner of Lone Wolf Pool Network. I'm sitting here with the commentator for today, David Baranski. A really nice crowd in Brass Taps today.
You know, Mark would be here if this was like Ronnie O'Sullivan or Mark Williams or, you know, any of those guys. Where is Mark? Yo, he's a pool player now. He's not a snooker player anymore. He should be watching this.
Yeah, he's watching it.
I mean, he should be here watching
it. Yeah, he should be here.
Tim, last I heard, he was at Rich's house, but I don't think he's still there.
Yeah, let's
Well, Mark, let's see if we can get Rich to get Ronnie O'Sullivan over here to do this.
Oh, okay.
Of course, we'll have to talk him into putting a snooker table in here too. Although Ronnie can play the hell out of some pool, too.
I don't know. They share it right now to like 17 pages, so I don't know.
So he wants to hit this as fat as he can. Anthony, you would be correct. He did. But as far as I know, he didn't go home winner. An interesting position play. All right, Red. There you go, buddy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay.
What did they say?
369. 369 is a clothing brand. I started it through pool as a way to give back to the community in pool. So each one of the numbers represent something positive from the Bible. So basically, I just use it as a way to give back through pool. I'll get you one tonight before I leave. Sorry, everybody. I had somebody come up and talk to me. All right, looks like Efren's gonna close this one. All right, I'll let y'all know what's up now. All right, who is this? Ken, he from Jacksonville. All right, so up next we got Ken, come all the way up here out of Jacksonville, North Carolina, so he can try his hat in the ring with Efren Reyes. Again, everybody that paid the VIP fee gets to play two racks with Efren, where they drew 20 names out of the pot, and they get to play two racks, and he looked like he chose 8-ball. Oh, he makes a ball on the break. Pretty much the way you want to beat Efren is to break and run. Mark Bolton, I don't know if he'll get the privilege to play Brad Sherr or not, because I haven't seen Brad.
Yeah, I was like, how's the weather to come out? I haven't seen all these people.
This is going to be an interesting shot right here to see what Efren does here. He's only got one ball left, but it's tied up. So it's like he's getting ready to try a kick shot here. Walter Hill beat this guy right here out of three sets Thursday night down in Jacksonville. Yeah. Walter Hill playing out of Raleigh from Maryland. Played against Ken down at Rackham Pub on Thursday night. They played three sets and Walter won all three sets.
No, Thursday and Friday and Saturday.
Okay, move on.
Uh-oh. Ken calls the eight in the corner.
That's what people from Jacksonville do, right?
Yeah. Man, Ken had a chance to beat him outright, and he just choked. He got a good roll out of it, but boy, I don't think I've seen a choke that big in a long time. Uh-oh. He's going to try that corner pocket again, it looks like. I bet the nerves got to him a little bit while ago. Oh man, that is twice. Wow, he can't say he didn't have his chances. He had two strong chances to put Efren down to beat him outright. Oh, Efren with the dirty save. Efren said he's going to have to learn how to Z-bank against me.
I'm Cinderella-ing the hell out of
him. Yeah.
Okay, you take care.
Nah, he can one-rail it. That ball's not frozen to the nine. He can one-rail it. Yeah. Oh, man. Bet this ain't the only time in his life he came up short. Efren gives him a second chance at it. Oh, Efren gave him two chances and stuck his tongue out and laughed at it, but now Efren's going to the table. Efren's going to give a little instruction here. He's going to show him how to do it. He's going to show him how to make it three rails. Watch this. Bring your stick to the right. Yep. Chalk it up. Oh,
Well, I bet y'all learned something right there. But either way, Efren takes the first rack. And now Ken gets to play him again. Efren is like a cat. He's toying with his food now. Having a good time here at Brass Tap Beds in Raleigh, North Carolina. I want to thank everybody for tuning in to Lone Wolf Pool Network. We really appreciate all the support. Just so everybody out there know, we work solely off tips and donations. So if y'all don't mind, follow the information at the bottom of the screen. And if y'all don't mind, go over and send us a dollar or two. We want to be able to continue sending y'all live pool action. Efren is going back to work now. I want to give a shout out to Ken Norton and Pauline. Thank y'all for tuning in. I think it's $10 after the exhibition is over to play him.
Really? But how does that work, though?
They just line up.
Just literally just, okay, $10 per person.
Yeah, it's $10. Efren, go ahead and closes out that one versus Ken. He run it out. All right, so who we got next?
J-A-Y.
All right, we got Jay up next.
He actually knows them from home, and he's still pretty.
That's called support right there, when you follow somebody around the country and play with them. I saw you showing sticks.
They know each other.
I know. That's what I'm saying. He's following them around. He knows them from back home overseas, and he's following them around the country to play. That's great dedication right there. All right, Jay, time to make a name for yourself, buddy. What's up, man? How you doing? I couldn't see the game. What game did they choose here? Nine balls? Okay. All right, so Jay chose to play two racks of nine ball. I think it's pretty cool how he smiles as he walks around the table like, ha ha, you can't make it.
Oh.
Victor. Nobody's winning this. They only play two racks. It's an exhibition. Each player gets to play two racks with Efren. And this is the first rack right here with Jay. Nice and smooth around the table. Nothing fancy. It's a great location of the cue ball. And Efren takes the first rack. We want to thank. I try to tell you, you don't have to have all that bottom English.
That's my mission in life, learn how to do that.
Efren makes the nine on the break. And scratched. Jay traveled a long, long, long way to play this match. I sure hope he gets one here. You know what my car looked like, right?
Silver, yeah. Like a silvery, yeah, Impreza? Yeah.
I need to get a cue ball. I need to get that cue ball out of the back of my car so I can get him to sign it.
Is Dave already out there?
Yeah.
He is, but I don't know where he is. I think he's smoking. He's not, I feel like he's been gone for a while, to be honest.
In the back of my car, you'll see it. It's a rack back there. Just grab the cue ball. Sorry, everybody. I'm getting a cue ball that we'll be able to raffle off. Getting the cue ball signed by Efren. We'll be able to wrap it off at one of our upcoming charity events. He thought he had snuck that one in there on the side. That stroke It's not just top English, everybody. That's a really good stroke. Great follow through. All right, Efren finishes that set. He wins both racks against Jay. Jay came all the way from the same country as Efren just to play him. Now I actually need Dave.
Joy, you're next, babe. After her, you.
Who's next?
Angela.
All right, so we got Angela up next. He's good. He's outside. He told me he was going. Yeah, you get to choose between 8, 9, or 10 ball. They only get to play 2 racks.
So 2 racks of 8
ball? Huh?
2 racks of 8 ball?
Uh-huh. Everybody's played 2 racks.
That's going to be long. ATM's out of order. They told us we gotta go get correct change. You gonna get an autograph too? Yeah, I didn't think about
actually, I already have a signature. A case that I had signed by, at the time, every living U.S. Open winner in 2001.
I need to get changed.
What do you need?
Sorry, man.
I just want to get this signed.
I need. Do it until Efren's done.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I need.
He'll set up back here.
So, do you think you're going to keep this as a streaming table, or are you going to move back?
I'm guessing move back because
you
won't be able to come here. Yeah, I would never be able to just sit right here because I'd always be in the way.
You got more players playing after this, but it looks crazy.
He's doing this until like midnight. We're not doing this. Started off with 20, but the VIPs are 50 of them.
And not all of them get to play.
God damn it, it's just 43 all, now it's 47.
Supposed to. They were supposed to play. I don't know what happened to that. He was up here practicing all last week. Hey, I wouldn't be surprised if she ran out here. She plays pretty decent. No, she's going to play that one last. Get her back on the eight. She's going to take the easy one to get in stroke. No, she take the easy one to get in stroke.
I would not either.
Me neither. I would have stayed on that end of the table first.
Because the eight ball's on this end of the pocket.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Angie. Let's do it, girl. Girl, you needed to drop.
She needed to drop the poopies out of that one.
You needed to get it to come off the rail.
She gets it wrong. She gets
scratched. Yeah! You go!
And Angie steals a rack from Efren Reyes. Boy, we won't never hear the end of this one, ladies and gentlemen. In Raleigh, North Carolina, this one will be talked about for the next 3 months. Who did she give her other rack to? She, all right, so Angie's giving her second rack to TJ. She's a seven. All right, so TJ, Angie's fiance, is up next. He's gonna play a rack in her place. Oh,
I think one TJ's gonna play the other. Yeah.
You're still on mute.
TJ was kind enough to run to Walmart for us and grab a USB hub.
I'm going to get change. I'll be right back. I'm going to get change.
You just need a 10?
Yeah.
I got 10.
You just said you got to have the exact change. Would have made sense. The ATM's out.
Dustin Fuller, the people that are playing him have all paid $50 to be here, and their names are being drawn out of a hat. So from what I understand, Efren's going to be doing this until the players are all accounted for, and then he's going to be setting up a table in the back of Brass Tap to do autograph signings. So if anybody wants to come here and get anything signed by Efren Reyes, bring $10 because you have to have exact change and something for him to sign. I know nobody can see this, but you haven't seen anything until you've seen a one-legged man dancing. Yeah, I said it, Nick. Dustin, there's not an exact time for that. It's going to be after he's done playing everybody, and then he'll do the signing.
That's his protege. Efren said, no mercy on you.
All right. I mean, he can screenshot that later, right? Just to say that he and Angie did the same.
What's his name? Troy. Oh, that's Troy. He always supports. Yeah, he's always on the stream. So one of our Lone Wolf top fans, Troy Godwin, is playing now against Efren. It's nice to be able to see, put some of these names to faces. We should have plenty of images for the website now. For everybody out there, just let y'all know, we got Elephant Pixels in the house taking pictures. So if y'all need any photography work, make sure y'all hit up Elephant Pixels.
I think I just heard that Machine is next. Machine actually wants him to play one pocket. I mean, that wasn't one of the options, but, you know.
That would be really cool if they let him play Machine and they play a rack of one pocket.
Because I know, you know, because he was playing Mike all night last night, he didn't get to play.
But if it was the last rack.
What's that?
If he's the last one, maybe. They might let him do it.
Maybe.
He played Mike today, too.
Yeah, over at Rich's house, yeah. Well, you know how much Machine high up on his bucket list.
It's pretty high on my bucket list just to be in the same building with him.
The first time I ever saw Efren in person was at the 1999 Camel Pro Tour 10 ball tournament in Charlotte. And he had this little guy on his back riding him like a horse, and it was Alex Pagelian when he was only like 15 or 16. He was young.
I was wondering if that was him.
No, Alex is, Alex is another Filipino, but he's a little guy who's a U.S. Open and World Pool champion.
Troy is a real smart player. Troy's got great cue ball control.
Doug, you just want more TV time.
We're about to learn something here. Everybody said that's what they would like, one game of one pocket. I'd like to see it, too.
Ooh.
Score now.
48-44, Dennis.
I may have missed it. Did Doug actually play? Hey, Nick, did Doug actually play yet? Has Doug played? Okay, because I know they called him.
Hey, Doug Parks, are you coming inside to play?
I mean, he was one of the first names that was pulled.
You want a blue?
Oh, he's sitting over there. I see him.
He just got here like 10 minutes ago.
Oh, look at this. That was a pretty good whack at it.
Thank you. Efren wins the first one. As soon as I get this sign, again, I want to thank everybody who came out and helped me make this possible today. Emmanuel Dean, David Baranski.
Alright, I'm cutting her off a little bit. Saving my last shot.
Make sure you get Doug. Okay.
I don't think he knows that. Really? Yeah, I don't think he knows he's supposed to play.
He does? Yeah, he told me to make sure I said at least two shots for him.
Yeah, but I don't think he knows that he's supposed to play.
Yeah, because he didn't break his sticks over here or nothing. All right, Efren runs that one out. Let's see who we got up next. Been a very fun, eventful evening here. Oh, that is Machine, everybody.
EJ, if you're still in the building, can you come see me? EJ.
What's up, brother? Good. You did good.
Fuck, I missed that four ball on this corner pocket. It made me want to vomit all over myself. I got a little out of line on it. I shot it before I even hit the cue ball. I was looking over at the five. I just got ahead of myself.
Bobby Brown, you're up next.
Bobby Brown, did he bring Whitney with him?
All right, so Machine's playing nine ball?
Yeah, I'm surprised he played nine ball. I would have figured he would have tried to play one pocket.
One pocket's not an option.
It's always an option for Efren.
Oh, well, she's asking everybody, eight or nine or eight ball?
Or ten ball, yeah, yeah.
Eight, nine, or ten ball, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just saying that if he went to Efren and said, hey, let's do one game for $200, Efren would say, okay.
Oh, sure. Sure.
And it's not like Machine can't afford it.
If people tag, they can show it.
You can still hear. I can't hear nothing in here.
You hear what?
She said that I couldn't hear none of that.
Oh, no. She was telling people when they were getting their VIP tickets, if you're allowed to video, as long as you tag the rest of it. So there's probably plenty of people in here. Just don't get our excellent voiceover. You said 100?
All right, so Machine, who is mostly a one pocket player, but actually plays pretty good rotation pool too, chooses to play nine ball. And Efren's off to the races. Dennis is up 49-45 in their race, by the way.
That's right, neck and neck too, huh?
It has been Since it started. Yeah. I think it at 20 games it was 11-9. Yep. At 40 games it was 21-19. Yep. I mean, it's just been neck and neck.
Oh wow. She's got like elbow tennis going on right now, and it actually kind of hurts for her to pick up a full cue. And she doesn't like playing with a lot of people. A lot of reasons, I think. But plus, you know, she wanted to give me a Father's Day gift, so she thought that was appropriate when she got drunk. Spent 15 minutes trying to talk her into playing them. So I was like, you should get up and play them. It's like a once in a life opportunity. Like the goat, you know? You get up and play them.
I mean, if someone, I don't give a shit if there were a million people watching, but if somebody said, you get to play a game with Roger Federer, I don't give a shit. I'm out there.
All right. Breaking your kneecap and everything.
I mean, nobody said I had to try. Right?
All right. That's what I explained to her. I said, she's like, well, I've been playing bad. I said, it doesn't matter. You're playing Efren Reyes. I mean, nobody expects you to win. And if you do, yeah, that's a bonus, right? So.
I don't know if he shipwrecked you on your break, but
somebody said something about it.
Rhodes has a good break.
And then nothing happened.
Yeah. Somebody actually commented. Somebody said something about it.
Yeah. That's okay. A lot of people have a lot of things to say.
No, he was defending you. He was saying you got racked.
Oh, there's a possibility of it. I don't know. I mean, I did not hit the break very well. I mean, I felt like I hit the one ball square.
There was one that Efren broke 10 ball and only like 3 balls peeled off. Yeah. And he still
played. Well, you heard what I said. I guess you couldn't because after I lost the first game and Efren walked up and racked him, like, make sure you shit rack them too. But
I wonder if he knows that Machine can play a little, because Machine got the broke pretty much, right?
Hmm?
Machine got the break, right? That's all he's done?
Yeah, that's all he did.
I'm sure he knows. Play. I think that Machine's been trying to set up a match with them forever.
Yes, he's been trying to play some more pocket. But he's trying to do like Mike did last night, just play some, you know, like $40 a game or something like that. Nothing big. I mean, Mike's been playing him for 2 days and basically is down like $60.
Yeah.
Well, Machine lost 2 racks and never got to shoot. All he did was break.
I assume that's Machine's daughter.
You hear that too?
Nice break, Machine. Everett's in stroke now. Anything else planned besides him just playing 20 people?
Nope. He is going to set up this table to do autographs.
Are you ready for the questions again?
He's not what?
They want to know, what kind of stick are you playing with?
Davini.
They want to know, how many different sticks have you played with in your lifetime?
Oh, God.
He cannot count that high.
Testing.
All right, the Jackie Chino now has played with since 2015.
Oh, Dennis did switch to a Q-Tech chef.
Kidding? Was that playing with the Teasley chef?
Same right here.
Hey, Rich, what's his name?
Bobby Brown.
Hey, what's your name again? Clearly, we're not pool players anymore. We're on this side of the computer.
Huh?
So clearly, we're not pool players anymore. We're on this side of the computer.
I'm leaving in a little bit.
Nope. Nope. What? Did you ask something? Where are the pits? I don't know what you guys have for this account. What you got? This far as I go planning.
Yeah.
Her family is bring up.
Off of an airplane to Taiwan.
It's okay. I think everybody that I have coming is vaccinated. Oh, well, I started like. So when they're coming in.
I would have loved to have seen George Crawford play him a rack too. That's good. I got Christmas to buy. I said, that's good. I got Christmas to buy. Marty.
Can you tag a point online and you go back into a replay? That shot he just made on the eyeball to get out.
You should be able to replay it from Facebook.
You can replay it, but
we can't not right now.
We can't, but we don't have it turned on. I'll tell you now.
Okay.
What's up? Can you tell me what the time stamp is now? It is
2 hours, 27 minutes.
You saw the shot, dude.
2:27.
Two he hours, 27 minutes.
Yeah, he did.
We got to turn that feature back on, though, because I use that when people are playing for money.
Oh, baby.
You going over there?
Yeah. My timer just went off.
4948.
I mean, I can't even tell. How many people? I don't
know how many people gone. It's got to be close to the end. 97 games, 51 breaking runs. Strongest gas.
Yeah. We probably be done here about like 9:30.
That's 15 minutes.
I know, but we're not gonna stream that part. Yeah, I'll see you in a little bit. Marty Good is a local tap player. Usually plays out of Shot Makers and Bucks Billiards.
Ball, and there's no argument at all.
Looks like he getting ready to try a two rail bank. All right, Efren gets out of that one. All right, so this is the match everybody's been waiting on. Doug Parks is up next versus Efren Reyes. Got to be a dream come true for Doug.
Kyle Nelson, where are you at? You want 8, 9, 10, you're next. 9, you're next, one.
I knew Doug was going to choose 8-ball. That's his favorite game. He loves to play last pocket 8-ball. I got a great idea for my next tournament. Remind me to go over it after this. Remind me so I can remember to write it down. Efren, Doug breaks, Efren runs out. Doug will get one more crack at Efren. Eight ball is a lot easier. Thank you. Well, at least Doug can say he made one ball against Efren. Yeah, way the table laid out, he might get another shot. I can't tell what ball that is right by the eight.
Shane's finally got the lead, 50-49.
Looks like a little bit of a miss right there.
He might use the, he might take the three and get around the table and break it out.
I think he's going to have to bank it or play it off of the 13. Yeah.
Or you could bank it short like that.
He's going to play a ton of inside, I bet.
Go ahead. Well, Doug got the break. That was about it. He did get to make a ball in the second rack.
So, 8, 9, or 10?
Yeah, I see.
You're next. You want to play 8, 9, or 10? He'll do 8, 9, or 10.
Point. We should have been keeping tallies. How many games has Efren lost tonight? How many games do you think he's lost tonight? Four?
He lost one to Angie. He lost one to
Melissa.
Yeah, he lost one to Melissa, and somebody else got one. Only three racks.
This looks like it's going to be a quick one, too. After 100 games, Shane Van Boning leads 51-49 over Dennis Arcoyo.
I like how they put the stats up. Ding. Look.
Who's the cook? Short side? Oh no, he's dragging it. Bad hit. Stretching out your leg?
Got to. Like I was standing up too long. All right, so Efren takes Chuck down 2-0. We got another local legend just joined the live stream.
Ron
Mike Fuller, welcome to the live stream.
Ron I.
Mike Fuller.
Oh, Mike Fuller. Mike and Peaches, you should be here. Although I know you played Efren before. Mike, didn't you play Efren at Derby City? I think I seem to remember that that was in your favor, wasn't it?
get it in, boy.
So I don't know if he knows it, but the last player of the night will be Rich.
Yeah, I don't think he know yet. I think they get ready to surprise him.
Yeah. And for those of you that don't know, Rich is the owner of Brass Tap. And he's a very, he likes to have fun, but he doesn't like to promote himself in his own pool hall. But Rich is a good dude. I don't think he planned on being on the stream or playing Efren, but I think he's going to. I mean, Efren's been playing on his table for 2 days, so I'm sure he's hit some balls with it. Oh, no, John, you're right. Efren didn't say a word about the break. He just went about his business. Did he call this ball? Did he call it in the side? He did. He's trying for it. Oh, play safe, Ron. He should play safe.
Thank you.
and didn't hurt him too bad. It's not an obvious open look here for the eight ball. But. Careful. Well, this almost looks like a drill. Just want to stay in the middle of the table, I guess. Oh. Oh, I bet he wish he had another shot at that one. All right, so Ron is going to give up his second rack to his wife, Heather.
My ears burn. You might talk about me.
Larry Ward said hello.
What's up, Larry?
Rich must know he's got his cues. Now, Rich, have you played him at home yet? You just been watching? So you get to do it here in front of everybody?
Yes.
I mean, I'm sure you're nervous, right? You don't give a shit, do you? So are you up next?
No.
There's still a few more? Okay.
I was shooting really good about 4 years ago when I got to play Ignacio, and I was looking pretty decent. He still beat me every set, but I got close. I was happy to shoot that. That was my favorite thing.
He hasn't.
Whoever Ignacio hit good back, he's slate master.
Yeah, he hasn't really come back much. I think he played in the U.S. Open 2 years ago. And I don't know that. Might have been 3 years. Yeah.
I got a cue ball.
Yeah, but get one for her or whatever, I don't care.
I got a cue ball to get signed.
Somebody's digging the booty rock tonight. You playing that for Efren? I know there's some man love in here for him, but I mean, come on now.
Did you ever see Ignacio in person, though, or
not? Yeah. He played in my tournament. He played in two of my tournaments.
He's one of the best offensive players I've ever seen. He's crazy.
When he first came to this area, Stan
Lowry brought him.
But he was a ridiculous offensive player. I mean, crazy. That's what's fun to watch.
All right, Efren takes down that rack.
All right, Heather.
Who? Heather? All right, y'all. Heather be up next.
I've never met him, though. I don't know that I've ever seen him in person at all. Omar hangs out with him a lot. Omar does pretty good. I've always wondered if they, like when they get to the finals of those big tournaments, do they do savers?
They do what?
Savers, like do a 60-40 split of the money, you know, something like that.
Most of them know. Like Omar definitely knows. But some of the ones like Ocola and stuff, I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised. People think it happened last year. I don't think James Geronis threw it off. But some people think James threw it off, but I don't know. Because if Geronis that year beat Ocola, he wouldn't have got second. Grand champion,
master of the table,
yeah. Master of the table, yeah. He would have changed the point somehow. I don't quite know what. I think Omar got third that year. 2 years right. This guy got first. I think he almost got second. What was that last year? I can't remember. I get my years confused. No, Moo was the year before. It was the year before Skyline.
Yeah.
It was the year before Skyline.
Yeah, but that was the year I was in the wheelchair.
It was 3 years ago than Skyline. So I don't remember who got first. It might have been Dennis Apollo might have got first then last year. It might have been 2 years ago. Dennis Apollo might have got first. But that's why people bought
James. The older you get,
I know, the years run together.
I mean, now I have a... Before I have my son... He's two. Before I had him, it could have been 2001, it could have been 2015. Now it's like, yeah, Hayden was one. Hayden was a year and a half. That's how I knew him. Time has no meaning once you get close to 50.
Yeah, Sky won the year before that because the next year, so Joy almost beat Dennis.
Who did?
Joy Tate almost beat Dennis the next time. Next time, because they was heel.
But I don't think James would throw off, but it wouldn't surprise me about Ocola. Ocola's all about the money. Yeah, I don't care.
That's better than me.
I was hoping that young lady from Jacksonville was going to get picked.
That one over there?
Yeah.
We who sat. Is she?
She plays at this bar in Jacksonville. She came up here and played in the tournament a couple weeks ago.
Was she ranked?
She was a 7. She ain't miss a ball. I mean, she didn't
just
miss
play. Actually, she's still playing with a turtle.
I played a 16-year-old girl last night. Played good shit. I forget what she was ranked, but she played good.
That girl didn't miss a ball. Now we watched her for about 45 minutes. She beat the mess out of the guy that comes down here out of Roxborough, Wayne Sutton. It was an 8-7 race. I think he got one game. Wow. The one I'm impressed with was the one where he went right off the nipple, 2 rails back to the corner, well, 3 rails back into the corner. That was, I could tell I'll be at Bucks practicing that.
Yeah.
this lift ball in hand.
That's table knowledge right there on a table that he doesn't really know, but that was inch perfect position. That one was not so much, but he got some separation.
So he's playing with a Davini cube. Rattles at home. Takes the first rack.
Allen, let me find out. I think he's...
Not far from it. There's like five or six pool halls right there, not far from each other.
Going up, down, back up.
So. Right. See if he'll stop by here on his way back up to DC. Allie, he is leaving tomorrow.
Who asked that?
Allie.
Well, he was here. He played here last night and today, so. Probably. And a little bit of it.
Yeah, the first U.S. Open I saw him at, which is in Chesapeake, they had this outdoor area. The weather was fantastic. He's actually playing for one game of chess at a time, $50 a game. My wife is Taiwanese.
Ricky, 10 Can you bring another cup of coffee, please?
I'm an IT guy. I do, it's hard to explain. Actually, it's not hard to explain. Like,
starting to get tired.
All right, so up now is Ricky. Ricky is the father of the little boy Eli that was playing earlier on the stream. He should play a jam up safety here. He should be able to lock him right up against the puck.
Oh, we got another local legend that just tuned in.
George Tomlin, he pulled off the upset last week and beat Efren down there in South Carolina. Thanks for tuning in, George.
Thank you. things too before you shoot. I work on my
All right, Ricky gets game one. He gets another rack. He gets the break. Let's see if he can break and run versus Efren. So Ricky splits.
All right, Andrew, let's go.
All
Andrew who?
Andrew Bruce? Bruce, yeah. Repping the game tight apparel.
Yeah, I see that. That's Tony's, right?
Yep. Tony Chohan.
Shane's up 58 to 53. Or no, sorry, 55 to 53. Yes, sir. Artie, he is going back to South Carolina. And then DC after that. Up a little bit short. All right, I think Andrew's done.
Andrew is ranked a skill level 10 here at Brass Tap, getting his opportunity to play with Efren. Chris Woodrum. How you doing, brother? Thanks for tuning in.
All right. Many people don't know this. Think about Brass Tap. Think about our tournaments. We're here every Thursday and Friday night, by the way. Quicken runs up to 10 grand. Starts at 7 o'clock. That's just a little shout out for us. But they didn't think, oh, I'm going to go see Tammy at the tournament. Oh, hell no, I'm not going there. Tammy's there. Nobody really knows. Actually has something to do with it once in a while. I may make the rules and do the bitch in and tell you to pull your pants up, but he pays the bills. So, Rich, 8, 9, or 10 ball. Efren said he would whoop your ass for me. All right, 9 ball.
All right, everybody, I think this is going to be the last match of the night. And this is Rich. What did he go with? 10 ball? 9 ball.
I'm impressed he actually wore a Brass Tap shirt today, you guys.
Question? Yeah, push to a jump shot? I mean, I don't think Efren will jump, but he did cover him. Got him again. Oh, a little.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's my mentor. When I was 12 years old, yeah. Mm-hmm. That's an old paper. It's gotta be old paper. Yeah.
Yeah, that had to have been close to when he and Parika came over, right?
Yep.
Around 84. Parika,
yeah. Somebody just said, ask him how he feel about Parika. Said, I will not.
I mean, that's...
Yeah, there's no need to...
personal business.
Exactly. There's no need to get involved in all that. Hmm?
Parika's still in the United States.
I think he lives in California.
Nah.
I think he lives in California.
I was about to say, I think he's on the West Coast somewhere. I'm not sure. If Big Guy was here, he could tell you. Yeah, he played, Parika played Tony Morrison here too.
Harold Dollar, there's a name I haven't heard in a long time. Hey, was that a good hit? I think he's being soft on the owner. What do you think?
Soft as a ball of cotton right now.
I don't know if anybody else has had five shots in a rack.
No.
No, you won't.
James, can you come over here, please, James?
Feel good? Feel good?
I feel incredibly lucky. I mean, who would have known?
It's a thrill, though, right?
Yeah.
Double the corner and come back down here.
All right, everybody, let me clarify. For the 6 and under tournament next week in Longwood Pool Network, you must be an active APA member or an active Longwood Pool Network Cash League member in order to play. Dante Smith, this is an exhibition, but he's playing everybody two racks. Everybody that's playing had to pay $50. Chris Morgan, thank you for tuning in, brother. All right, everybody, I want to thank Rich for allowing us to come out here and live stream tonight. Again, I want to thank everybody who came out to help me. Emmanuel Dean, my co-host, David Baranski. He also helps me with a lot of the IT stuff. Really appreciate everybody coming out and supporting.
Hey, I'm just glad you give me something to do on the weekend besides babysit.
It's rigged.
All right, now nobody has gotten two.
Yeah.
I'll give you $1,000 if you three foul him.
Yeah. Go for the three foul. Rich is about to say, this is why I own the pool hall.
Yeah. Yeah. We gotta really get saying this is why you get to stay at my house.
Yeah.
While you're visiting. Good job, Rich.
All right, so when she told me today, you never beat the owner. Because that pool time goes up to $10 an hour. Pizza's 20. Coffee's 10. And we live by that little tool machine. All right, we got one last one. We didn't call him out earlier. And we didn't let him know, but Shane is with the United States Marine Corps, protecting our country, and he's about to be deployed. So, Shane, you are our final match.
That's so my buddy from...
We're waiting to get autographs for pictures, and we'll come out on that side. If you have your own picture... to be autographed or autographing something is $10. Take a picture with them, it's $10. We have 8x10, 5x20. Again, we'll start the line on this side, the table, and go that way.
I want them.
Shane.
Dean, I need somebody to get in line first for me.
Sorry. Let me see if.
In line first for what?
Wait, I'm gonna sign this. She said she's going to start the line over there. Over there. At the end of the table. That way we can start breaking down and.
So Shane is from J-Town, right?
Yep. Shane is hoorah from Jacksonville. Plays out of Rackham Pub and Biggers.
Jacksonville. That's home of the few, the proud, the animals.
What was that? Nope.
Somebody must be watching a video or something. I don't know what that was.
I got to keep it straight. The line ain't started yet.
Come on, Shane.
Not sure. It'll definitely be on Facebook later on and Twitch, but I'm not sure about YouTube. We'll see what we can do. We were trying to put it on YouTube tonight.
I should be able to save it from Facebook and then upload it anyway.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, that's going to take up a lot of space.
Y'all shared some YouTube.
Well,
it's on mine. The first video we shared went there. For some reason, I'm thinking it's going to show up later like the other one did.
We'll see.
Mm-hmm.
I remember thinking, why is somebody using that carbon shaft? I know it's your night off.
That's where we're going. All of us going over there.
Sound is there. Are you going to get an autograph?
Are you going to talk to me on here?
Welcome, James Blackburn. Did that set last week, or is it this week coming up?
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Pretty good, bro. Good. Did you see that? Dean, did you see that shot? What was the time stamp on that?
Says 33. It must have restarted
because
it says 33.
Yeah. Just know it was at the very end.
Go after the 8 ball here? Yeah. Gonna have a shot. Yep. Tell you what, Shane doesn't look like he's old enough to drink.
No, but he's getting deployed, I think, in August or the end of July.
I don't think that was a surprise. Get him, Shane. Second. Get him, Shane. Get dead.
Take this W back to Jacksonville.
I don't know if you could hear Efren.
Oh shit.
Going four rails. Ugh. No fair talking to the balls. Uh-oh. That might not end well. Four rail that one.
Autographs line is starting right here. Not going in any other way. This is it.
So Shane is not old enough to drink. His brother just posted. Well, he had a couple cracks at it to win, but he didn't. All right, everybody. We want to thank everybody for tuning in. That was the last match tonight for the stream. Again, we want to give a shout out to Brass Tap Billiards for allowing us to come in and stream. Tammy and Rich did a great job hosting this event. Thank you again for David Baranski coming out and helping commentate. And also want to thank Elephant Pixels for coming out and doing photography work and also helping us set things up with the live stream. All right, everybody, it was a great night. Really appreciate all the support. Y'all have a good one.